Hello people, here I am again with my beer at Christmas, and today we are 23rd of December, so here it is, 23rd of December, the beer is best served from 8 to 10 degrees Celsius, and it pairs really well with cookies. Okay, let's see what it is, guys. So, this one is from America, from Founders. And the name is Marvel Roast. And I'm going to read what's on the bottle. It's an Imperial Golden Ale with coffee, cocoa nibs, vanilla and milk sugar. Okay, so it comes in at 8% ABV and it's 20 IBUs for those who do care. But that's not much, of course. And it's a 355 milliliter bottle, actually. Let's get it open and see how it looks and smells again and tastes like, of course. Right, there it goes again, my cap. Okay, let's get a small glass. It's actually a taster glass from one of those beer festivals, but this year there was no, I think only one beer festival that was actually happening in Belgium. Okay, let's get it on the nose. A lot of chocolate, vanilla, like the cocoa nibs are very present. Okay, let's taste it. Yeah. A lot of cocoa in there. A lot of cacao. And vanilla, okay, vanilla and cacao, you get most of it. The milk sugar, that will be the lactose, that makes it more creamy. It gives it a more thick feeling to it. Like that, and the color, like you can see, is like straw yellow colored. But this could actually be a brown one or a black, if they used different malts. But this one is, I don't know why it's actually clear, because it tastes like a stout, actually. So that's another twist to it, and I do like those twists. Like when you see this, you could immediately think, oh, that's a blonde, or that's a saison, or something like that, or a pilsner. But no way. It is really tasting like a stout with all your coffee in there, and your cacao, your vanilla, your chocolate. Like, it's, there are some raisins in here, you can get it. It's rather bready. It doesn't feel like 8% ABV. It is rather smooth drinking. So, a nice beer from the US of A. The Marvel Roast. Yeah. I'm gonna give this like 7.5 out of 10, guys. And now for my second beer, because we do always, most of the time, two. And this one I got in, like you could see on my video before. I really wanted this one. Look at the label from Amager Brewhaus. The Jule Juice. I don't know how to pronounce it, but it's actually a hazy winter IPA. And I don't know what I mean by winter IPA. Okay, the hazy part I get, but the winter IPA, I don't know. There's a lot on here, but it's really small. It's impossible actually for me to read, and it will be too much to read actually, because it's all about Santa. Yeah, it's a story actually. Nothing more on there. Best served 6 to 10 degrees is also on there. So Pilsner malts, Carapils malts, Haver malts, rolled oats, Hummel, root oats, Hummel. I don't know. Oh yeah, those are the hops. So rolled oats, and then the hops come. They are like Columbus, Citra, Amarillo, and Mosaic. They used for this one. I don't know how it will taste, but it's 6.5% ABV. That was I also searching for. Okay, Let's get it out. Is drunk best before the 2021? It's best for that date you actually drink this, and it's batch number 2412 because it's all on there. Okay, let's get it out and see how it looks. The really nice can, really nice brewery, and really cheap beers, like you could see on my video when I went to Bierhalle de Koning in Vichte. These are like 3 to 5 euros for actually a big can, because this is a half a liter, if I'm correct. Okay, let's get it in a glass. Oh, the winter IPA, this looks really nice. I was expecting a dark one, like a dark IPA, like a black IPA in Tightmoor, but it's just as hazy winter IPA. Yeah, the winter part I still don't, but I'm sure I will get it on the nose or in the taste, what the winter IPA means. Yeah, okay, so looks really nice, really hazy. It's like, yeah, like white to yellowish color, a mixture between that, but it's really hazy. A thick 2.5 finger head. Okay, let's get the nose. Hop bomb. Yeah, for sure. Really fruity, and because there are really 4 hops in there, if I'm correct. I didn't mention it before. But I think, yeah, 4 hops to this, and there are all aroma hops. So these hops do give like these really fruity tones, notes to it. Okay, let's get it, guys. Cheers. It was actually better on the nose, because I do get this milky thing again, that lactose that's in there. You can feel it on the mouth. It's really thick, and you get that milk flavor, like, because they make it now these days. A lot of them are made actually with lactose added. I'm not really a fan of that, but that's my personal thing, of course. You might like that, but for me, it could be even more hoppy compared to some of those real hop bombs. This one is like also bitter. Yeah, it has a high bitterness to it at the end, but you do get your grapefruit and your pineapple and your oranges in there. These things I get like up front. Otherwise, it's rather well made, but not in your highest top of IPAs, of course, but really nice label for the price. Guys, really, for 4 euros or something, this one was like 4 euros. Come on, guys. What an amazing beer. And it's really smooth. It drinks away really fast. I can easily get down this can in like, yeah, 10 minutes or 15 minutes. This is one to actually don't let it stand for a while, like your stouts or your porters or your barley wines, that you got to drink real easy. Sometimes take a sip of it. This one you can drink much faster, actually, because but I like IPAs. The style IPA I really prefer most above the other styles. But you know, when you had so many beers, when I started, I'm gonna tell you a story. When I started, I had no like cell phone, which was actually connected to the internet. So I had just a cell phone with some, still you got to touch these buttons, not with the touch screen. Let's say it's like, so it wasn't a touch screen one. And then I got my new cell phone, and it was the one that was touch, and I could go on internet. And then I discovered the app Untappd. And from there on, actually, it all started. So I was really curious about this app Untappd. And I was looking, oh, I got a new beer and I get this batch. And yeah, it was really, and from there on, it all started. And I wanted to search as many different beers. And then in the beginning, I was only liking really the blonde, like Pilsner's blonde and IPAs. I did like the ambers, but not that much like the brown ones and those black Russian Imperial Stouts, the porters, the barley wines. I really didn't like when I started in like 2016 with the app. I did have my now and then my Belgian beers, but like your regular ones, you know, when you're at a pub. We can get more Belgian beers here, of course, at the special pubs, and I don't live far away from a special pub that has like 200 or 300 beers. So, but those are not actually, now and then they do have some craft breweries, actually, some microbreweries, but most of them are well known, like your Duvel and your, you know, Gulden Draak and all those ones. But that's how it started. And then I got to really like the styles I didn't like before. I really was enjoying them more and more every time I had one, like a stout or something. And now I drink almost everything. The thing I won't drink, I don't like, are those, you know, those ciders, the apple cider and stuff. I didn't make them also. I did homebrew some of for me, actually for my girlfriend, because I'm not a fan of it. But it's actually really easy to make. And no, I'm not a fan of ciders. For the rest, you can give me about everything. Everyone has his own favorites, of course, when it comes to a certain style in beers. But no, I'm going to give this a rating, guys. If I haven't done it before, I can't remember, but I think I didn't. No, I didn't give it a rating. Is this better than the other one from Founders? It's an all different style, so you can't compare. But I'm gonna compare it to other IPAs. So I'm gonna give it a rather strange rating. Okay, 7.25 out of 10. I'm gonna give this maybe 7.5, also like the other one, but I'm still thinking. Because there are better IPAs, actually, to be honest. But yeah, maybe I can give 0.25 more rating just for the label on its own. Actually, really cool labels these guys from Amager Brughas make. Yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna round up. Cheers, guys, and don't forget, a beer a day keeps the doctor away. Tomorrow we will do the 24th, the last one from our Beery Christmas, and from then on we do, yeah, special ones, maybe one beer a day again, like more special ones, like these ones, or like I got a lot from brewery at Eltje from the Netherlands. I got some from Kees, you know, you have seen it in my video. I did film them all of them. All the beers, but it wasn't easy again being alone and holding the camera and pushing the cart, the shopping cart, forward. So, and I did also notice the quality isn't really high on, because I don't understand when I did the video and I watched it on my cell phone, it was really nice quality. And when I did upload it to YouTube, they did something about the quality of the video. I don't like it, actually. I might re-upload it again, but I don't know now. I'm gonna see if people do actually complain about it in the comment section, and they say, oh, not good quality, I couldn't read the labels or something like that. I will try to re-upload it in maybe even higher quality, if possible, of course. But on my cell phone, it is really nice quality. I don't understand. But okay. Cheers, guys. And don't forget, a beer a day keeps the doctor away.